boat. You dirty scoundrel. I'll never forgive you for this.
Hello?
Listen, I know you're technically on vacation right now, but we've got breaking news. There's been a museum theft in Venice, and suspect number one is none other than, wait for it, La Volpe.
La Volpe? The fox? He was supposed to have retired. As much as I wanted some time off, I can't pass this up.
Since you're headed to Venice anyway, you won't have to change your travel plans. My contact there promises an exclusive. He's waiting for you at Cafe Casanova.
Buongiorno. I contacted your editor at my employer's request, as he wishes to remain anonymous, at least for now. I know you hoped for a scoop from me, and now that I've met you, I wish I had more to offer, but I'm only the messenger here. My employer asks that you begin with this package. It contains the clues you need. If I were you, I'd start with the package. You can trust me. There's nothing dangerous inside. My employer keeps a low profile, leaving clues in clever places. Have a look at the table next to us, as he's left something for you there. It's been a pleasure to meet the famous journalist from the States, but I must leave you to your investigation. Ciao!
Thank you.
Don't trust him. He's playing you. You're going to get hurt just like I did.
Hi, Signora. I was supposed to see the bell tower with my girlfriend, but got stood up. These tickets are going to waste.
Chell, foreigner. I hope you're a paying customer, unlike these cheap tourists we've been getting lately. And you better have ID. That's my new policy in case anything goes missing. Ah, a journalist. You should write a story about that thief, the fox. He probably hit my kiosk. One of my souvenirs is missing. Well, you journalists are good for something, eh? Let me repay you with an ice cream. Here's the key. Help yourself.
Grazie. So you want my bell tower ticket? There's a great view from the top. Just ignore the mess from the renovations. Here's the ticket. Just stamp it at the booth and head up. It's not crowded. You'll only be the second tourist today.
There's that strange woman again. Uh-oh. When was this elevator built? The Renaissance?
Oh. Ciao Bella, you look lost. Perhaps I can help you find someone. Ah, splendid. Your persistence is admirable. Allow me to introduce myself and explain why I've brought you here. I am La Volpe, or as you Americans would say, the Fox. No need to call the police. You see, I've been framed by my ex-partner, a lovely woman whom I believe you've had the pleasure of meeting. My retirement was not a fiction. The theft part of my Robin Hood act ended more than 5 years ago, but I've continued to give to the less fortunate as befits my means. And Gabrielle threatens to undo me. I need your help to clear my name. In return, I'll give you an exclusive, in-depth interview. The only one I've ever given. I'm sorry I won't be straightforward with you, but Gabrielle's cunning requires me to use cryptic methods. You'll have to follow the clues, and avoid the traps I've left to throw her off. Here's the first clue to get you started. Thank you.
scusi. You're saying that someone left our water truck in the middle of the square? My apologies. That was Enzo with his head in the clouds. That'll teach me to hire an artist again. I'll have him move it right away.
Buongiorno, signora. You are the American journalist, right? A man came by earlier and convinced me to put myself at your disposal. He said that you will know where to go. Ah, the Hotel Vivaldi. Your friend has good taste. We'll be there in a moment.
Why are you stalking me? I'm just here on a story.
What? Oh, hi. Sorry. Welcome to Hotel Vivaldi. You have a reservation? I just need to see your ID. Oh yeah, some guy already paid your bill. Here's your key. Have a blast.
Thank you.
Hey, I almost forgot. The guy paying your bill left this box for you, too. I'm not even sure how you open it. Not that I tried, but anyway, here you go.
Bravo, you have found the first tape. Now go to the Venice Museum and search for any evidence my ex-partner may have left behind. I left a couple other things in the hotel that may help you. Good luck finding them.
Thank you. I'm sorry, but due to a recent burglary, the museum is closed to all visitors. Wait, you're that famous reporter from the U.S., right? You helped those kids at Linden Shades. Orphans. What a story. That must mean you're here to cover the Fox's crime. I suppose I could make an exception in your case. Here, you'll need this card to get inside. I heard you're pretty smart. See if you can guess the security code for the door. I'll give you a clue. It's the year Marco Polo returned from Asia.
Greetings. I'm certain La Volpe has sent you here to clear his name, but like his namesake, he can be equally charming and cunning. He is the one behind the theft, not me. Take a look around if you want the real story. He can't know I've been in contact with you, so I've left instructions that only you will be able to find around the museum.
Just what do you think you're doing here, journalist? Turn around. Slowly now. Let me tell you a little something. Off the record, of course. I'm Inspector Carlo Lombardi. Who let you in? The guard? Sorry to be rude, but everyone is a suspect. So, you're here to cover the theft. No harm in letting you look around, I suppose. But remember to share your findings with me.
Thank you.
Why, you have a knack for this after all. So, Vernaza, this isn't just an old postcard. Someone wants to be found. Come on, I'll drive. You see, La Volpe and I have a long history. He's my biggest failure. He slipped from my grasp one too many times, and he stole something very dear to me. Can you imagine how I felt? Well, I won't fail again. This is my chance to settle the score. I'm going to see my old contacts. Someone knows something. You stay here, and don't get into trouble.
You're the American journalist, aren't you? Gabrielle told me you might come by. We're childhood friends. She used to spend hours here. I think she's in some kind of trouble. She asked me to give you this. I have to go, but please help her.
Thank you. Thank you.
I stumbled upon La Volpe when I was working. Of course, I knew who he was, but his charm won me over. A new chapter of my life began. We had our differences, but I was willing to overlook them because for the first time, I was truly happy. He promised to stop stealing and disappear with me. It was all arranged, but then he betrayed me. Now all my memories are bitter, and everything we had is ruined. The Renazzo Watchtower is like a broken beacon of our love.
You saw her. Where is she? I haven't seen her in years. She might be the answer to my prayers.
She's at the cliff. But she was meant to be here. It's you. Gabrielle meant to meet you here, but I think she had a bad feeling. If you can get the cable car working, you'll be there in a flash. Oh, and light the lantern, so she'll know it's you.
Thank you.
Lombardi? What's his connection with Gabrielle? I must talk to Gabrielle. I need answers, and she has them. Where's Gabrielle?
Sorry about the wild goose chase, but there's someone from my past, someone I hurt, and it's all too much for me now. I just want to tell my side of the story. There aren't a lot of people I can trust. I gave up my life for La Volpe, and this is how he repays me? Look at this.
Gabrielle, it's really you. So many years of silence, and yet I've never forgotten you. You broke my heart when you left the case and ran off with that thief. But now we're together again. Come on, reporter. There's room for one more. I won't believe it. I loved you, Gabrielle. But never mind. We have a chance to start again. You'll take me to La Volpe.
I've told you 100 times, Carlo. We can't ever be together again.
Look out!
from around here, are you? I usually come after school to watch the sunset. It's usually so peaceful. There was a man with a woman. He looked angry. I think she was hurt. He took a boat and left in a hurry. You can't cross the lake in any of these, but I saw a motorboat in the boathouse.
Is everyone blind? Can't they see his threat? They call me incompetent and obsessed, but the police should do anything to bring this villain to justice. I have but one goal. The end of La Volpe. Even if it means the end of me as well.
So, we meet again. It's no accident. I followed you from Venice. Lombardi has a house on the other side of the lake, and that's where he must be holding Gabrielle. We'll need to hurry. It's almost dark. Can you grab a reflector from that compartment? We need it on the windshield. When the Marco Polo situation began, I needed an outsider. I still loved Gabrielle too much to think clearly. Of course, I had a few trusted friends.
How'd I miss something so obvious? They were here to help me do what I couldn't do alone.
Now you know. That villa at the top of the hill is Lombardi's. If we split up, we might be able to catch him off guard. Be careful. He's dangerous. You better get some help and find another way inside.
You look like you've been to hell and back. Mario, go get help. Just don't go back to the villa on the hill. A terrible man lives there. Some say he's just a policeman with an attitude. But then, how could he afford that villa? Rumor has it there's a secret entrance to it.
Yeah.
There you are. So Lombardi's the one behind the theft in the museum? He knew my interests in Marco Polo artifacts, so it was easy to frame me. When I was a child in the orphanage, I owned a single book, and it was about Marco Polo. I'll trade my freedom for Gabrielle's safety. Take this in case I don't make it. It's the interview I promised you. Now, let's hurry.
Is everyone blind? Can't they see his threat? They call me incompetent and obsessed, but the police should do anything to bring this villain to justice. I have but one goal, the end of La Volpe, even if it means the end of me as well.
I always dreamed of being rich when I was a child. Still, I never forgot to share with those who suffered as I had. I was safe in my creed. I never stole from anyone who didn't have enough. But then something unexpected blindsided me. Love. Gabrielle helped me stop running from the ghosts of my penniless past. In her eyes, I found peace. But all beautiful things end. And this interview is my first and last confession. Make it count.
Don't move, you two. I wouldn't hesitate to hurt our little heartbreaker. I've got you where I want you, La Volpe. The famous thief about to beg for mercy. This is where it ends. What are you trying to prove? No one will believe you.
Good job.